Thank you for taking a moment to learn a little bit more about Windy City Fieldhouse's Amazing Race and Mission Impossible scavenger hunts. The Amazing Race is one of Windy City Fieldhouse's news programs. We've been doing it for about a year and it's been unbelievably well received. If you're familiar with the show, you get a little bit of sense about what the event's going to be. As we like to joke with people, there are two primary differences. One, unfortunately your event isn't going to be televised. And two, you aren't going to span the globe. But you will crisscross the city. Lincoln Park Zoo, Wrigley Field, Chinatown, Greektown, Navy Pier, you name it, those are going to be part of the destinations that you're going to try to go to during this event. The Amazing Race is usually a 3, 4, or 5 hour event. And how it starts is that one of our MCs is going to kick off the event. Each team will have a facilitator, and after we kick off the event, each team is going to be given 25 destination clues. Now I'm going to give a little bit away with the strategy here. What those teams should do is try to solve those destination clues first. They're pictogram, brain teasers, various other types of trivia type questions. Once they've defined what those 25 destinations are, they really should try to map it out, and then once they've mapped it out, learn how to get there on public transportation, because they're going to need to take the L and other forms of public transportation and try to get to the various locations. Now, even in a 5 hour event, they're not going to be able to get to all 25 destinations. That's where the strategy comes in. They can't be up at Lincoln Park Zoo and start heading to Chinatown and realize, oh my gosh, we were supposed to go to Wrigley Field. So the key is for them to really strategize and ensure that they're doing things in the most efficient manner. The clues, depending on how far away from Michigan Avenue they are based on different point totals. The closest to Michigan Avenue are worth about 10 points. The further destinations are worth about 25. So a team can't just stay on Michigan Avenue and win. Now, each destination also has a mission component. So once they've defined the destination and they go there, their facilitator will give them the mission component. For instance, the Wrigley Field destination is once they get there, they need to take a picture of their entire team underneath the awning with one of our Polaroid cameras. Our facilitator would take that. In addition, to get extra points, they need to go across the street in sluggers, and two people need to combine to hit 10 pitches, they don't need to hit them well, in the batting cage. Once they've done that, now they've accumulated all the points for that particular destination and mission. They should move on to the next. The only mandatory destination that we require is that every person on your team has to get a slice of deep dish Chicago style pizza along the way. That way this event, especially if it's longer, also serves to provide a meal for people. Each team is going to be given spending money, and they're not allowed to use any of their own money. The other key differentiator, by the way, between this and the regular show is that, first of all, teams won't be two-member teams. They'll be teams of about 8 to 12 people. And additionally, we're not going to have people go in a linear order, point A, point B, point C. They will have their 25 destinations and can choose which order they want to go to. As I said, they're not going to be able to get to all the destinations, so that's where the strategy is going to come in. Very high energy, very popular event. Been incredibly well received. Great way to see the city. Now our Mission Impossible program is very similar, except it's a little bit more low-key. It's going to be based just on Michigan Avenue. You're not going to use public transportation, and it's more of a 2 hour event versus a 3, 4, or 5. One of the key features of both our Amazing Race and our Mission Impossible program is that there's a facilitator on each team. Without that facilitator, the level of sophistication of the event can't be very great. By having that facilitator there who gives out the mission clues once you get to a certain destination, we're allowed to make the event far more complicated, far more sophisticated, and far more competitive. Otherwise, the clues would have to be so basic to ensure that no one got lost or off the beaten path that it would have to be a very, very watered-down version. So one of the things that we specialize in ensuring that these are very sophisticated, very complicated, makes it competitive, that's what makes people have fun. Plus the facilitator can kind of keep people on the straight and narrow, ensure the group doesn't just end up at a bar and just kind of relax. They'll keep them moving and going along. Once you understand your budget and your time frame, then you'll know whether the Amazing Race is a better fit or the Mission Impossible event. Thank you for taking a moment to learn a little bit more about our Amazing Race and Mission Impossible scavenger hunt. I'd be delighted to speak with you directly about your specific mission objectives, as when we talk to clients, nearly 50% of the time a client tells us that they want to start with a scavenger hunt or they want to do a scavenger hunt, they end up with a team challenge. It's not that the Amazing Race and Scavenger Hunt aren't wonderful programs. You get fresh air, get to crisscross the city, walk around, very different from the traditional work environment. But when we're talking about their specific mission objectives, one of the challenges with the Amazing Race or Scavenger Hunt is that you're only going to be with a small subset of the people who are participating. Whereas with the team challenge, your whole group gets to stay together. That may or may not be important to you, but if we can chat, we can figure out what are your specific needs. You can reach me directly at 773-486-7403, or you can fill out an RFP online and I can get back to you. Once again, thank you for your time and consideration.